fine tuning here. Gone up and done this bit on his eye, which has two, actually he's got two lines there. It's just pink, very, very thin. So I've done the pink first. Probably why it didn't look dark enough, because it didn't have the line quite right on top of his eye. I knew something wasn't right there. As soon as I saw it in the darker light last night, I knew that it wasn't right. It needed to be darker. But part of the problem was that I didn't have that black line, a smidgen down. Just the merest smidgen makes all the difference. The overall correct look of it all. And this black line now has got to come. Yeah. Just fades off a bit at the end there. In. Just gonna just fade off a bit there. That's it. And then just pop that there, because it's got another little mark in there. And then, yeah, that is right at the top of his pupil. That needs to go up a bit. Quite straight. There's another little mark there. Okay, that's it. Now I need to put more pink in there. Needs to be darker, dark and down just a smidgen. That's pretty good, I think. Yeah. Yep, that's it. And we've got some grey hairs around here. Hook at the end of it there, and that means it's got to come down that way a bit. Yeah, that's about right. That's it. Such a beautiful cat. see what's going on with the nose. Bit of blue, I think, in the nose. Let's try and get this nose on the way here, I think. Right, I've got a bit of that, yeah, that's that there. That's coming straight around there. Just sort of makes it a bit greyer, the blue on top of the dark grey. Is good. Just giving it a bluey look, which is soft, which is lovely. Right, this is blue here. And I can see that's used to be a blue back there. We've got a bit here that's coming up. A dark bit there and then a lighter bit. The orange, I think. It's getting a bit lost that bit. It's a bit darker in here. Darker in there. Carry on there. And then lighter. Just here, we're going round here. Yeah. That's far too thick. It's got a bit of orange in there though. And it's coming up. Coming up across. That's it. Yep, it's looking better. some more writing again. Just going up here. Yeah, there is a bit of shadow in there, a bit of blue. We need to put that back in. Gonna get this bit of shadow in here. So, yeah, so this is what I tend to do. I tend to go into a lot of detail and then I just knock it all back, and that way it seems to work. Seems to work. Because if you like to do get all the detail in, which I do really, it can easily look a bit overworked and a bit fussy. And all you see is the detail, you don't see the animal anymore. What I want is to really get a, you know, I want you to see the animal and think, oh, what a fantastic looking cat. Amazing, all the different colours in this cat. It's incredible. Really incredible. think. Pupils a little bit high, so I'm just going to knock it back down a bit. It's dark, dark, dark green. That'll be better. We need light green in there as well now. That's there. I think what I'd like to do next, I think, is to make this a nice bit wider there, because it is very wide, isn't it? Thank you. just thin these out a bit with the black. See? Isn't that nice? So nice. So good. So good to do. I really love drawing. Absolutely love it. See a bit that needs attention there, and it's this bit here. It's got to come over a bit. It's got to come up here a bit. Together with that. And it's not that dark, so I'm just going to lighten it up with an orange. Yellow. Separate it up a bit there. That's it. Just be a little line there. What I'm going to do now is put his pink nose in, and what did I do for his nose? 188191. Yeah. So white on first. So I'm just gonna go lightly over it with white. Just get a base in. Not a strong base. Keep the grain of the paper, because that's going to be very useful. That's it. And this is actually pink under here too. So we can fill that in with pink white, because we're going to fill that over with pink after. Yeah. Under his black nostril there. Too big there at the moment, but don't need to worry about that. Right, so that's coming there. This is all going to be incorporated into his top of his lips. Got that black mark there. It's quite thick there, isn't it? Just following the lines of my that I put in early on to get the direction of the hair. that's pink. Then we've got this more coming down. And then across. Like that. They're the direction of those hairs. Very white up here. So I'm just going to follow that line. This line now. It's not really pinky pink, it is a kind of orangey. Just going to put those in now. That's where the line was. Then pink up to there. A bit of black in there actually as well. Yes. And you see we've got the black line there, but we can go over it with the pink now because it is dark there. So just putting in the patches of sort of orangey pink, I suppose you'd call it. Now just looking at something there, doesn't look quite